Ladies and gentlemen, let's start our Superalloys. At first, I have a brief introduction of Superalloys. Maybe some of you have been this introduction also. So, there were some important things that we ought to make Superalloys. That comes from the after World War II, that these Superalloys has been developed. Because of turbine engines and jet engines has been to be more and more reliable for the industries, and the decreased dependency from strategic elements that is an issue for countries like USA and Britain that was dependent on this alloy, making to use something to be more and more economic to have this. You see, that time during the Cold War, it was a critical need for U.S. aerospace unit for the spaceship and something that was used this super alloy to develop their production about this. But something that was in the Zaire and Zimbabwe, some African countries, they couldn't supply these elements to the market. So America needed to have some strategic resources for this. They started to develop superalloys. Now in this discussion, I want to tell that one superalloy that was very needed in aerospace needs for increasing flight speeds. So we will have this. Okay, as I told you, the requirement for superalloy. We have to concern in this. We need adequate strength at the surface temperature, resistance to oxidation at the surface temperature and non-surface temperature, adequate ductility both at room and surface temperature. You see, in surface temperature, maybe in some cases in the turbine blade, the temperature getting very high in about 900 degrees Fahrenheit. So we must have a certain strength of our metal to be enough strength, you know, to this temperature. So we need to withstand the thermal shock in this situation. Ability to manufacture process and to make desired shapes like foundries and rolling. We need to accommodate this. And for the next topic, there's two basic super alloys that consist of nickel and cobalt base. That nickel base, the chromium, can be seen here. Some you see in the cobalt super alloys. Some super chromium has a very significant role in super alloy cobalt. So that this chromium will be evaporated in vacuum. The needs to be made this alloy was to increase the chromium in the aerospace that there is no oxidation resistance. So they decrease the chromium. So there is some things that we use by this alloy, like turbine blade, transportation, cogeneration system, combined cycle power system. And these are also a methodology in cycle that's been used, foundry and SN302 is the cast cobalt based alloy, having a super oxidation and thermal shock resistance. It was designed primarily for use as a first stage turbine vane to operate in temperature range 1500 to 1000 Fahrenheit. This superalloy was very critical for the U.S. industry after the World War II. They need to develop the country, so they need more power generation. This alloy could be very useful for them. This application is in turbojet engine, turbine, turbo buckets, turbine engine combustion chamber component, advanced ship, space power system. In space, there are many, there is a very strong facility that this must have a very good resistance over something. That this alloy can be used in power system in space. Biomedical. You see, there are more usage of this application is biomedical and some key element in magnet steel. Cobalt has very good role in magnet steel, but it is not super alloy. But it is an important alloy. Cobalt is radiographic inspection. It has a very good emission of the some gamma ray, gamma photon that can be good for inspection. And the manufacturing technology is consists of induction melted under argon gas and vacuum melting greatly improves the surface of appearance of the casting. You see, this alloy, super alloy, also can be used in vacuum chamber furnaces. You see, in vacuum chamber furnaces, the alloy must be very resistant over vacuum evaporation. You see, some alloy has very high evaporation in
Oh my god.
Finish off the pitch.
Finish.
You have a lot more?
Yeah. It was for designed for 10 minutes.
Is it?
Yeah.
Not for 5.
So where is your partner?
He's alone. He's alone.
Shall we add another 3 minutes for him?
Yeah.
Okay, you have to directly go into your theater. Okay. Not too much on the American transactions. Okay.
You see, there was a reason that I chose this thing for our study.
Yeah.
You see, we are engineers. We must know the material, we must know the application, we must know our limitation.
Yeah.
We must know the strategy over some strategic elements.
Yeah,
that we cannot find anywhere. We must know how to optimize usage of these elements. So that I mentioned this here. So we need to focus on something areas that we need to do that in our industry. You see, in some industries we don't have enough elements to cope our needs. So we need some other sources to use instead of it.
Okay, we have 3 more minutes left. Maximum 3 more minutes.
Okay. You see, the main cobalt structure is HCP. But in the high temperature, it gets in FCC and can be machined and rolled very good, very well. And there is less fracture in the edge of rolling. And can be have high thermal shortening. And this is rupture test over some different super alloy. And we don't have time. It is over the 1800 Fahrenheit. Measure. This is our distracted over our stress. And this is okay. And this one. This is conditions for our tensile properties of this alloy. In the cast and sheet. Cast means direct casting and sheet means after rolling. In room temperature and 1800 Fahrenheit. We have a good elimination about this and ultimate tensile strength. We can see it is decreasing and can be maintained in this. And this is compression strength structure properties also. And this is tensile properties over. The workability, chair cast slab, hard roll at 2150 Fahrenheit, up to 0.06 inches thick without edge cracking. It is a good, very good properties of this element. Cold rolling is proper for low chromium intermediate anneals. It means when it is rolling, some and in curing happen instead of this. Can be formed into complex shape for radiators and ducting components in power spaceship.
And this is oxidation resistance and potential application. These ones have more potential application. Industrial vacuum furnaces, as I told you, turbojet engine component as combustion chamber and tailpipe and stator vane. Excellent resistance to the thermal shock in 2100 Fahrenheit. Our reference is NASA development in cobalt based and something.
Okay. Boleh? Got a lot of things inside here.
So it's good to get it good. I'm pushing with the time. Okay. I think you need to practice only before you do the presentation.